Spirit, the three, who created, redeemed, and who washed my soul clean. In love I am bending my knee. Blessed to me, blessed to me, as with angels and saints, so with me. Each shade and light, day and night, time in your love, in return. May Jesus show us each day your smile and your wisdom, your grace and your will. In awe and wonder we pray.
Bless to me, as with angels and saints, so with me. Each shade and light, day and night, time in your love, O Spirit, blessed to be. Blessed to me, as with angels and saints, so with me. Each shade and light, day and night, time in your love, O Spirit, blessed to be. O Spirit, blessed to be. O Spirit, blessed to be.
Good morning, and welcome to this worship service brought to you from St. Mark's Presbyterian Church in Orillia, Ontario. We recognize that the land on which we live and work and worship and play here in Orillia is the traditional home of the Anishinaabeg, specifically Ojibwe and Chippewa people. We also recognize that June is National Indigenous History Month. And with the growing revelations of the harm done by the Indian residential school system, we pray that we might learn how to better engage together with all First Nations people in meaningful acts of healing and reconciliation. At its meeting last Monday, City Council was addressed by Chippewa of Rama First Nation Chief Ted Williams, who also engaged with council members in a moment of silence for the lives lost at the residential school in Kamloops. Later in the meeting, council received details of a new virtual learning library comprised of local stories and Indigenous teachings. And we look forward to more of these kinds of conversations and partnerships that reflect a new and more positive relationship. As we gather virtually for this time of worship, we also share the shock and sadness at the intentional killing of a Muslim family in London, Ontario. We continue to learn about the cost of prejudice and hate, even here in Canada. My name is Gordon Timbers, and it's my pleasure to be filling in for the Reverend Linda Patton Cowie, who has been busy this week with responsibilities related to the meeting of the General Assembly of the Presbyterian Church in Canada. Commissioners and resource persons participated from their various locations across the country. And throughout the week, other interested people were able to log on and watch the proceedings. And if you missed the live streaming, recordings are still available to access by clicking on the website www.presbyterian.ca. Reverend Linda will have much to tell us, and we look forward to her report. We're thankful for the leadership team here at St. Mark's for making this worship service available. Mary Jo Wilson, Maryllis Dongelmans, Linda Piercy, and Pauline and John Freely are providing a beautiful ministry of music. Larry Windrem is our tech expert, and Irene Malik distributes the services for each Sunday's broadcast, and all of these efforts are very much appreciated. Today's service continues the series Reverend Linda initiated last week on the ancient Celtic understanding of blessing. She helped us to realize that blessings are not restricted to the special or out of the ordinary. Rather, blessings are everywhere and in everyone and in everything. Our life, day by day, is the ongoing experience of the presence of God, a blessing that is as all-encompassing as the air around us. Last Sunday, we learned how we can increase our awareness of blessings by actively looking for them and then offering prayers of thanks as we go about our living. When we get up in the morning, our prayer can be, "Bless to me this new day. Bless to me this cup of coffee and this piece of toast. Bless to me the safely distant greeting of a neighbor. Bless to me another chore done," and so on. The theme of today's service is Holy Moments, celebrating the gifts of life. And that theme is highlighted in the words we sing in the introit, "God to enfold me." And reading Psalm 148. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise God in the heights. Praise God, all angels and the heavenly host. Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all you ocean depths. Do the same, fire and hail, snow and smoke, stormy wind that does what God says. Do the same, you mountains, every single hill, fruit trees and every single cedar. Do the same, you animals, wild or tame, you creatures that creep along and you birds that fly. Do the same, you kings of the earth and every single person, you princes and every single ruler on earth. Do the same, you young men, you young women too, you who are old together with you who are young. Praise the Lord. Psalm 148 is our inspiration for our opening prayer. Let us pray together. God, we thank you for all your gifts. This day, this night, these fruits, these flowers, these trees, these waters, in love, you have endowed us with all these treasures. the heat of the sun, the light of the moon, the songs of the birds and the coolness of the breeze, the green grass like a soft mattress, all owe their existence to your grace. God, may we forever breathe your love and every moment be aware of your presence in all you have created. And we pray together as Jesus taught, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. God, in great mercy, forgives what we have been, helps us amend what we are, and directs what we shall be, so that we may delight in God's will and walk in God's ways. For all this we say, thanks be to God. Amen. And the hymn is number 304, We Praise You, Creator. Last week, during the taping of the service, something happened that didn't get picked up by the microphone, so you wouldn't have heard it while you were listening at home. What you missed was Lori Windrem working very hard to stifle a sneeze. And even though she sneezed very quietly, I automatically wanted to say to her, God bless you. Maybe you do the same thing when you hear someone sneeze. Now, the question that came to my mind about this is, why do we say, God bless you, when someone sneezes? What I learned is that a very long time ago, when there weren't doctors around like there are today, people thought that when someone sneezed, there was something wrong, and that person needed some help. So people said a little prayer, God bless you. Another prayer people sometimes say is Gesundheit, meaning good health to you. I also learned that our bodies use sneezing as a way to clear the nose. You know, when dust or pollen or smoke gets into our nostrils, the nose becomes irritated or tickled. You've had that feeling, I'm sure. And when that happens, our bodies do what needs to be done, so that the dust or pollen or smoke doesn't go any deeper into our bodies. The sneeze clears it away. So another way to look at it is to think of the sneeze itself as a blessing. The next time we have to sneeze, we can remember to say, "Bless to me my sneeze." Thank you, choir, for that beautiful anthem. And as we come to scripture, let us pray. God, give us open minds to receive your word, understanding to know what it means, and the will to put it into practice through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. For our scripture reading this morning, I'm going to do something a bit unusual. I'm going to take one verse out of the longer passage in Luke chapter 12. It's a longer series of verses that are part of the teachings of Jesus about a whole range of things like coping with possessions and handling money and fulfilling responsibilities. And in this longer passage, Jesus speaks of the powerful hold worry and anxiety can take on our lives. And that is certainly something that health and spiritual care providers have been very aware of in helping people who have been negatively affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. But for this morning's purposes, my hope is that by looking in particular at Luke 12:27, we can make a meaningful link to our new worship series on blessings. Jesus said, "Notice how the lilies grow. They don't wear themselves out with work, and they don't spin cloth. But I say to you that even Solomon in all his splendor wasn't dressed like one of these. This verse does offer a warning about worry and work and anxiety, with the advice to trust God to provide. That's the point made in the larger context of chapter 12 when Jesus points to the birds of the air and how God provides food for them even though the birds don't plant seeds or harvest crops or build barns or storehouses. And then Jesus puts the question, can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? The teaching about the futility of worrying is very clear. But through the perspective of this worship theme Reverend Linda initiated last Sunday, I saw something new about verse 27, something that gave me a new understanding of blessing. And this new awareness starts with the very first word of the verse. Notice how the lilies grow. Take note, consider, really look and see and appreciate not just how the lilies grow, but notice, really look and see and appreciate everything. Dina Metzger is an American writer and poet, and in one of her books, she says, each day is a tapestry in which threads of broccoli, children, building, planting, thinking, all interweave in intimate connection. She says, sometimes we can become so focused on our own accomplishments that we fail to see the holy, sacred, healing grace of God present all around us. Sometimes we might think of ourselves and our situation in life as kind of ordinary. We're so used to it that we don't really think about it very much. But Dina Metzger says that there is nothing ordinary about the gift of the ordinary. Seeing things differently, rediscovering a sense of wonder about ourselves and our world, that rediscovering takes root in the fertile soil of the simple sentence, I never noticed that before. Think about the last time you said those words and the feeling of wonder that came with them. Metzger expands on this beautifully when she makes the observation that to say, I never noticed that before, is to say in that moment, I am welcoming and inviting new life. I'm allowing myself to short-circuit the experience. I'm not allowing myself to short-circuit the experience of wonder. In true moments of amazement, we take notice of the wonder we are and the wonder all around us. And these moments of awareness and appreciation, they're what keep us going in the flow of our day-to-day living. And of course, the gifts of the daily and the ordinary can come in very different and sometimes strange and peculiar packages. Some of them might border on what we may think of as inconvenient or even sometimes irritating. You know, those times when something happens that wasn't in the plan. Something happens that gets our attention. We notice the delay or the interruption. And when that happens, we have the wonderful opportunity to get a different perspective by asking ourselves, how can we find something positive, even joy and delight, in this moment of life's inconvenience? I've often had this experience when making a wrong turn while driving somewhere, and actually been able to enjoy the experience of discovering a part of the country that I wouldn't have known otherwise. I can also tell you that I've learned that it's good to start out with a full tank of gas when enjoying these unexpected new places. So the next time any of us are thinking our life is slightly off kilter, it may help us to remember that in many ancient societies, if you came to a a shaman or medicine man or priest complaining of being disheartened or dispirited or depressed, they would ask one of four questions. When did you stop dancing? When did you stop singing? When did you stop being enchanted by stories? When did you stop finding comfort in moments of silence? And notice that the question isn't, when are you going to stop worrying? Worrying isn't the focus here. The focus is on noticing, being aware, being alert, being receptive, being responsive, being thankful, and being open to receive and then to share blessings. The Celtic tradition is built on stories, parables that are told and retold because of the wonderful teaching tools they are. And in that tradition of sharing teaching stories, I invite you to listen to the story called Owning Beauty. The story is that the richest man in town had a collection of fabulous jewels, which he kept securely locked away in a safe. One day, the local parish priest called. I have heard that you have in your safe the most valuable jewels, the priest said. Would you allow me to see them? It would be a pleasure, the rich man said. I haven't looked at them myself for some years, so I too will enjoy seeing them. The rich man opened the safe, took out the gold box filled with the jewels, and then spread the jewels out on a table. Both the priest and the rich man stared at them, awestruck by their beauty. Then the rich man put the jewels back in the gold box, returned the gold box to the safe, and locked the safe door. Thank you for giving me those jewels, the priest said. But I haven't given them to you, the rich man protested. They belong to me. The priest replied, I have had as much pleasure as you from looking at the jewels. So there really is no difference between us, except that you have all the expense and all the anxiety of buying them and looking after them. That very day, the rich man gave away one jewel to every household in the town. There were just enough, with one left over for himself. I think that's a lovely teaching story from the Celtic tradition, and this little parable reinforces the theme that we're considering in our worship services for these next few weeks. The rich man discovered a new way of living, a way of living in which he noticed his blessings. And with that new awareness, he shared blessings with his neighbors. We can also live in this wonderful awareness that we have been blessed, and that we can be a blessing to others and to the world around us. And in this new awareness, we can pray, bless to me this wonderful promise and potential. Amen. Now, a beautiful hymn about blessings. This is My Father's World, number 328.
And to my listening ear.
As we come to our prayers for the world this morning, I'm going to begin with a pandemic prayer that I think fits well with our theme of noticing blessings right where we are as individuals, and then we'll broaden the focus to include our community and wider world. Let us pray. God, we don't know when we will be able to gather together again in praise and thanksgiving. So for now, we ask that when we sing along in our kitchen to each song on the radio, that it be counted as praise. And that when we read the news and our heart tightens in our chest, may it be counted as lament. And that when our eyes brighten in a smile behind our masks as we thank the cashier, may it be counted as passing the peace. And that when we water our plants and wash our dishes and take a shower, may it be counted as remembering our baptism. And that when tears come and our shoulders shake and our breathing falters, may it be counted as prayer. And that as we sit at our tables and eat one more homemade meal, slowly, joyfully, with nothing else demanding our time or attention, may it be counted as communion. And now, God, in common concern, we offer our prayers for ourselves and for others. We pray for you to send your peace, your comfort, your healing presence into the places of deep sadness where so many people find themselves and for so many different reasons. We know of people who have been wounded, people who have experienced disappointment, people who have aching hearts, sometimes for their own actions that they now regret, sometimes because of the harmful actions of others, sometimes because of forces beyond anyone's control. We ask, God, that your Spirit would move through all these people and places and situations, bringing comfort and strength, bringing healing for broken hearts, bringing freedom from fear, and bringing the courage to face forward. Bless to us the awareness of your presence with us and of the potential we have to be agents of your blessing in ways that will bring wonder and amazement as we give ourselves over to your will and purpose, a ministry that we see so clearly in all the words and actions of Jesus, in whose name we pray. Amen. And again, a hymn that speaks of blessings all around us. All of life is filled with wonder.
Thank you.
As we go from this time of worship, may your joys be much more than your sorrows. May your hopes outshine the gloom of despair. May your faith be stronger than your discouragement. And may you always know that God is above you, under you, beside you, and inside you, now and forever. Amen.